This is a 2001 Corvette C5. I'm going to show you how to take off the door panel.
First step, put the window down and pop the hood.
To do this job, you need a few tools. First, a small standard tip screwdriver. This one, you can get this pretty much at any automotive supply place, is a door panel prying tool. This is a T30 Torx screwdriver. See the funny end on it? Gotta have one of these. And this is a 5/16 ratcheting socket wrench, and this is for the removal of the battery terminal. You need these to take the door panel off. Next, take your 5/16 and disconnect the negative lead of the battery. That's this one, the one with the negative sign. This one has a plus. The negative terminal is closest to the engine, and the side terminal is what you disconnect. And always facing the bolt, left to loosen, right to tighten. So just loosen it up. You're going to hear some crackling noises maybe and a little spark, but don't worry about it. Just push it off safely to the side, make sure it can't come back. So you've got one, two, three, four pieces to remove before you can take the panel off. You can start any order you want. Take your flat blade screwdriver and pry loose a little cover right under the door handle and put it somewhere safe. There's these screws underneath here we'll have to get to in a minute. Starting with the window, power window switch and door lock button, pry it from the front like this, not from the back. Pry it up and it should come out like that. And keep prying from the front, jiggle it a bit, and then pull it this way and it should come out. It has a little tang here. You might find some parts broken when you're doing things like this because other people have had a go at your car, but hopefully they haven't. It's got an electrical connector on it, and right there you squeeze it and pull it off. I had to squeeze that little tab right there. Next, I'm going to take off the door handle trim. I'm going to start at the front of it here, pop it back, and work my way around it carefully. Always careful with plastic parts. Here we go. As much you can do with your fingers, the better. There we go. Take that off, and again, have a look at, make sure things aren't broken. If they are, you'll need to replace it. Take that off and put it in a safe place. And lastly, we've got the reflector. Pry from the bottom, and it should come out. Next, take the T30 screwdriver, and you'll find some Torx bolts right under the handle, two of them. Remove them. Next, get your door pry tool. And there's six pins that hold this panel on. One, two, three, four, five, six. Starting anywhere, but I prefer the back here, gently get your pry tool in here. A little cracking noise is normal. Go around, gently. Put your hand in there if you can. Try to feel for it. And both hands under if you can. And start pulling. And right, panel should lift off like that. Just take it now and put it in a safe place. Once the door panel's off, you can do various repairs that you might want to do. You've got the door handle, the door handle control here, door lock, the mechanism, This is the door control module computer. It's for the power windows. It has relays in it for the power windows and the power door locks. The speaker, of course, and various connections, so you can do all your repairs once the panel's off, including removing the glass if you have to, or changing the mirror. Putting the door panel back on is simply the reverse. Couple things to check first. You can see the white pins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Make sure they're on the door and in good condition, not stuck in the holes. If they are, you have to remove them first. Might have to buy new ones. Why did they break? They might have broken when you took them off. They might have broken from a previous repair. So take the panel and put it back up here. Try to line it up. And it kind of hooks up in here first. So this is the part that you've got to tilt a little bit and bring her down. Check the side of the doors. And of course, feed this electrical connection up to where it's got to go, which is of course the power windows. So keep that up there if you can. Get this aligned. And you can feel it with your hands, or you can get in there and see if you can see with your eyes.
This one's a little bit tough. Oh, there it is.
There you go. Try to get this top one started. That's it. And don't lose that electrical connection. There it is. Okay, once that's done, push on the door. You can see it's all going in, and then give it a shot. And it should be tight, fitting all the way around. It should be even up top. And take your T30 screwdriver and your two big bolts, and that'll be the next thing that goes in. And if you put the panel on right, these should go in no problem, shouldn't be stripped or anything. Put one in loose, put the second one in. These ones, give them a good crank. That's your door handle. You can't break them. I like to give them a good crank. You can put it back together in any order you want. Just put the other pieces back in. Make sure that's on. Take your power door switch, power window switch, I should say, and orient it correctly. Switch, the connector will only fit one way. There we go. Put the back end in first, down like that, no other way, and then shove the top end down. Fits beautiful. This one, the door trim piece, the handle trim piece, put it on the rear first, slide it that way, and feel it, and push that on, and it will fit snug all the way. And you're done. All you have to do now is hook up the battery and make sure everything is working okay. Power window switch is working, power door locks. Thanks for watching Car Questions, and remember to please subscribe. Thanks.